Hey y'all, so today, as you can tell by the title, this is going to be a review product video. So the last couple of months, I've been purchasing items left and right. I've been trying out new things. I've been seeing a lot of reviews of these products. I've been recommended by a lot of people about these products as well. Yes, today I look full glammed with the hair done with the Nike shirt. Oh well. So with these reviews, I'm going to do them month. Whenever I see a YouTube video, I automatically have to get a product that someone else has recommended, or, you know, me looking at other people's videos and I'm just like, I got to have that, honey. So as y'all know me, mostly my Snapchat fam knows me so well because I am on there 24/7. I keep it 100. So what I mean by that is that I'm not gonna sugarcoat things. I'm not gonna express something that I like about a product and then not end up being so well. So here are my honest opinions, and for all my videos I will keep it honest with all the products that I purchased, to keep it real with everything that I use. Let me talk about the products that I purchased. I have a lot of stuff. I have skincare, I have foundations, I have liners, I have so much stuff here. So yeah, so if you girls want to keep watching this video, then stay tuned, y'all. I'm going to start in a random order, from talking about the good products and then talking about the bad products. So the first thing I'm going to talk about is this product right here. This is a brush cleaner from Cinema Secrets. I love to use this product when I am on the go freelancing and I have to clean my brushes in between clientele. So this wastes no time. So what this does is you just spray a little bit on your brush, wipe it off, and it dries super quick. So this has been one of my favorite brush cleaners. I want to try another brush cleaner. I forgot the name of it, but I am going to try that out as well. But at the meantime, this is one of my favorites and I have not switched to any other brand brush cleaner. So Cinema Secret. The next thing I want to talk about is the Candy K Lippy. Now, this one's by Kylie Cosmetics. I know there's a lot going on with that company right now, but honestly, this has to be one of my favorite lippies of all time. I absolutely love the texture of this. This lippy in general is super, super comfortable to wear, very long lasting. And this for me, it is the perfect nude pink shade. It's very low tone. It's not so bright. It is absolutely beautiful. This has to be my go-to lippy 24/7. I mean, I have all the collection, well, some of the colors, and definitely there are different textures of each color. So this one, that's why it's by far one of my favorite ones out of all the colors. And there's one negative one, so stay tuned for that one. Another brand that I've been loving so much is Dose of Colors. Now, Dose of Colors has amazing lippies. Now, amazing shadows, matte and shimmer pigments, you name it. I absolutely love that company. It never disappoints me, ever. One of the things that I've been so obsessed with is the Ideal Duo Eyeshadows by Dose, and this is in Pixie Dust. I have another shade, I think it's called Shell. I don't know, I'll double check. This is a dual thing. So it comes with a cream shadow on top, which I absolutely love. You can wear this by itself or you can actually use it with another pigment. You use a cream first as a base for the actual pigment itself of this shadow. And I absolutely love this to highlight. I absolutely love this to use it on bridal makeup. So you can tell how gorgeous. You can't really see, but I love this thing. This is just the pigment itself, and you can see how bright and pigmented this thing is. So imagine with the cream shadow before that. I am definitely going to purchase more of the colors that comes with. I don't like usually buying everything all at once. I want to try out the products first, and this one is a yes for me. Another product that I have been super obsessed with is, if you hear the music in the background, that's Darlene, my daughter, deciding to, you know, play some music. Anywho, another product that I've been super obsessed with, that I'm so glad that I've tried this out, is the RCMA thinner that I got from Camera Ready Cosmetics. It is the shit. I don't know how else to put it. It's the shit. I absolutely love this thinner. I mean, it makes everything super creamy, super flawless, especially for my dry skin clientele and for myself, since I have some dry areas on my face. This thing does wonders. It really makes any type of heavy foundation, any full coverage foundation, a little bit more softer and a little bit more creamier. Leaves the face more radiant, more flawless, and it's just so amazing. I absolutely love this. I feel like every artist should carry this in their kit, especially if you work with different types of, you know, skin tones and skin types. This is amazing. So speaking about face product, I finally purchased a product that everyone's been raving about, and I obviously had to try it out. This product has been used as a primer, and if you guys can tell, I got the Nivea Shaving Balm, and I've heard great reviews about this primer, so of course I had to try it out and see for myself. At first people were telling me that there has been different types of shave balms. When I got this, a lot of people were telling me that this wasn't the one. A lot of people were telling me this was the one. I was like, beauty. I'm just like, whatever, I'll just try this one out. And I tried it out a couple times, and it's cool. I like it. I don't love it. I like it. Tends to get a little bit sticky, which is perfect for applying foundation, because obviously you want a primer that's gonna grab the foundation to make it last a little bit more longer. So I tried it out a couple times. I mean, I'm going to try it out obviously in the summer, because I'm here in Arizona, and y'all know, Arizona heat ain't playing. This was only $7. I'm gonna go ahead and keep trying this out, but as for now, I like it. As for an eyeshadow palette, I absolutely love this palette. This is the Violet Boss Pro Holy Grail palette. This has been my go-to palette. I have not switched to any palettes yet because the color range of this palette is so amazing. It has some mattes plus some shimmers. I actually am wearing this right now, and I absolutely love the pigmentation. The colors are like butter. They blend super easily, like it's super effortless. You don't have to poke your eyeball to actually blend the product out. It literally does it for you. So the range of colors is just amazing to me, because this is absolutely perfect for beginners. It comes with shimmers, some brown tone colors, and it's easier to start off with colors like this. Easier to work with from light to dark. You could absolutely customize it as well. They have some dark shimmers here, some really dark brown. So yeah, so this is my go-to favorite palette. For foundations, I have tried every foundation that you can name of. I am a foundation freak. I love spending my money on foundations, because I feel like the main part of my makeup is my face, pretty much. I want a nice foundation, and when I have a nice foundation, all my makeup comes together. You can have a shitty eye, you can have a really bad brow day, but if your face is still popping, nothing will matter, trust me. One foundation that I've been absolutely loving is the Milani 2-in-1 foundation. And this foundation, first of all, is very full coverage. It definitely reminds me of the MAC Studio Fix foundation. It lasts all day. For my dry skin people, I know full coverage foundation sounds a bit scary, but even if you mix this foundation with the oil or with the thinner that I talked about, it really, really blends, and it makes the foundation very, very flawless and thin and smooth to the face. So for my dry skin people, don't be scared to wear a full coverage foundation. You can absolutely mix and create your own texture to the foundation by using oils, and it definitely helps a lot. So you definitely want to try this out. I think it was $10 at Walmart. Their foundations have improved so much. When I started freelancing, I used their old foundations that they used to have with the little brush, and those sucked. So when they came out with this, I had to try them, and they absolutely changed their game. So check this out. Another thing that I've been trying out for the first time ever is the Jeffree Star Lippies. I absolutely love his lippies so much. I love how comfortable these lippies are. I mean, I only ordered two shades, and this one's in the color Red Drum, and I forgot the other one. But this one, I love the pigmentation. I absolutely hate matte lippies. I can't stand how uncomfortable they are. So I don't mind a matte lippy. I just always place some gloss on top. I just want the colors, but obviously this one by Jeffree Star has been super comfortable. I have not complained whatsoever. It's very long lasting. You don't need to touch up at all. And I absolutely love this color. So if you're still debating whether to get some Jeffree Star lippies, I really, really suggest that you should try just one, but I absolutely love it. Love it, love it. Another thing that I've recently purchased, and automatically I fell in love. I've seen this brand go all over the internet, and I've never heard about this product before in my life until I've seen Makeup by Aloe, Benny Beauty, you know, other artists using this product, and I was like, I have to try this out. First of all, I absolutely am obsessed. I don't think I could say love. I'm gonna say obsessed. Fucking obsessed. I love this thing because not only does it really hydrate the skin, it really leaves behind like a very dewy, radiant finish. And I use this to apply on my bare face first. This is not technically a setting spray. This is excellent for using before makeup application. It's definitely like the Max Fix Plus, but I feel like this, I think this one's a little bit more healthier. It has awesome, beneficial, healthier ingredients. It has only herb and rose water. So with this, it just really, really soothes the skin. So I spray this before any makeup foundation, any powders or anything, just in my bare face. Then after, spray it again once I apply my creams, my concealers and contours, and it really helps to blend everything together. I got this at Ulta and it's only $7. $7. Darlene, $7. $7. I really want to try the other product skincare stuff as well, so I'll probably come back next month to do those reviews as well. Last but not least, I've been loving this moisturizer. This is from Belief Cosmetics, and this is absolutely amazing for a very dry skin, or for any type of skin tone actually. First of all, it smells so bomb. It's just a splash of water to your face. I apply this every night. I apply this before any makeup application on myself, and leaves your skin and foundation very, very smooth. I got this at Sephora. It's about $25 to $30. I'm not sure exactly, but it is actually, it carries a good amount of products. If you use it on yourself, it'll probably last you for a while. All right, so let's move on to the things I hate. So the first product that I absolutely hate is the L'Oreal Cushion Foundation. Now, this foundation, I was so excited to try out. I've heard nothing but good reviews. It says buildable luminous foundation. I mean, my skin is obviously different from everyone else. Maybe it works on some, maybe it doesn't work on others, but I've tried it out plenty of times and I just hate this shit. The coverage is not there for me. At first when I tried it out, the pigmentation of this foundation was perfect. Then after of a couple uses, it starts to fade away as I go. Really creases up my makeup, only because since it's super, super, super water-based and super, super creamy. I've tried different primers with this foundation. I've tried setting it with a little bit more powder and this still doesn't work for me. This one was a no-go. Another thing that I absolutely hated, and it is another drugstore foundation, is the infamous Infallible Foundation. Now, this product has been used by a bunch of people, and this one is very popular as well. But for me, I just feel like with the creams and also primers, what really, really sucked about this foundation is that my pores would show out so bad. My pores were just so visible with this foundation. And again, I tried so many primers, so many ways into setting this, and nothing helped out. So after that, I just gave up. I was like, you know what? I don't like you. And I did get my exact shade foundation, but what I've noticed is that during the day, it really makes your skin really, really dark after. So it oxidizes as the day goes by. Make sure you purchase a foundation, the Infallible Foundation, a lighter than your actual skin tone, because then later it's just gonna get darker, honey. So sadly, this was a no-go. But again, if you girls have any tips as to how I can use this foundation better, let me know. I'll probably try it again, and next month I'll come back saying that I love it. I mean, who knows? Last but not least, here is one of the main products that I absolutely hate the most. This is the Quartz K from Kylie Cosmetics. Now, again, like I mentioned, all her lippies have different textures and pigmentation. I feel like with darker colors, they need that extra more pigmentation to make the color pop way more, since obviously it is a dark color. But this one does not apply well to my lips. There's some bold spots even if you apply three coats, or even if you go to that extent, it starts breaking off. Whoever says Quartz K is an amazing lippy is a liar. Scammer. I'm just kidding, don't take it serious. Whenever I hear people say that this lippy is so amazing, I'm just like, how? How? Please let me know if you girls have any tips again to make this. I mean, I moisturize my lips. I exfoliate my lips just to make this lippy work. I've tried a bunch of dark lippies before and I've never had a problem with any of them. And this one is just horrible. Again, not all her lippies are great. I mean, this one came out bad. 22, which is the orange shade, it creases and it never lasts for me. But my Candy K and Dolce K and Coco K, those are my favorites. And the pigmentation of those are obviously different. So again, this one was a no-go for me. All right, girls, so that was it of my whole video. Let me know what you girls think. Let me know any tips and tricks to fix the no-go product. Again, I'll do these every month. Every product that I purchase, I will do a review. I actually have a skincare routine product that I've been wanting to do. Let me know if you want a separate video, talk about that in full depth. So let me know what you girls think about this video. Subscribe, comment, like it, and I'll see you girls soon.